بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والعاقبة للمتقين، ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، أشهد أن نبينا محمدا عبده ورسوله، صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، أهلا وسهلا ومرحبا. Welcome up brothers in Islam to lesson 172 of العربية بين يديك, book 1, part 1 of the new version. وقفنا عند الصفحة 110. We have stopped at page 110 عند السطر الرابع من الأسفل, at the fourth line from the bottom. إذن so 60 كيلا 60 كيلوس 60 كيلا 60 كيلوس. You might find in some of the prints of العربية بين يديك, old prints, the word كيلون or كيلان with the فتحة on the كاف. And now it has been changed to kilan, and this is the correct opinion, wallahu a'lam, for the word kilo. So the word kilo, my brothers in Islam, is normally al-aslu wal-aslu, and the root form is kilun, kilun. So kilun is a kilo, and this word, and Allah knows best, might not have been present in the long past, in the time of the Salaf. It might not have been there, and Allah knows best. I haven't come across any hadith, and I haven't read except for a very few ahadith, but I have never come across the word kilun. Yes, we have sa'un. Sa'un is a prophetic measurement. Sa'd alif ayn. Sa'un is a prophetic measurement, and it looks like a cylinder. It's a cylinder shaped measurement, and when filled completely, it's between 2 and 3 kilos, depending on what you put in it. So if you put flour in it, it will not give you the same weight as putting dates in it. If you put something light on it, it's not like putting something heavy on it. So between 2 and 3 kilos, and that is what you give in the morning of Eid al-Fitr. That's what you give out. That's what you give out to the poor people in the morning of Eid al-Fitr, before Eid al-Fitr, on the first day of Shawwal. So anyway, kilun, and Allah knows best, it might be taken from the English word kilo. And there are some other measurement types in the ahadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, other than the word sa'un. But anyway, kilun is a kilo. وفي النسخة الأولى, and in the first print, من العربية بين يديك, كيلا, okay, بفتح الكاف, the فتحة on the كاف. وفي المعجم, and in the dictionary, يعني في المعجم العربي, in the Arabic dictionary, we find it even with a waw, not only with a lam, كيلون, but كيلو. And this brings us even more closer to the English kilo. So كيلو is a kilo. So you can use kilun, you can use also kilu, depending what you find easier. So for many, this might be a bit easier because it's similar to the English version. So kilun, but if you say kilu, but if you say kilun, just like in the book, then that's also fine. So you either use it with a waw after the lam, or you drop the waw and keep it on the lam like in the book. So you say kilun or kilu. والجمع And the plural for both of them is كيلوات. As you can see, هذا كما ترون هذا جمع مؤنث سالم. This is a sound feminine plural because that is always with ألف open ta. So we have a feminine plural, كيلوات. Don't forget to put الشدة on the واو. لا تنسوا وضع الشدة على الواو. Don't forget you lot to put the shadow on the واو. كيلوات. إذن وهناك وهناك طريقة أخرى. There is another way للتعبير عن هذه الكلمة, to express yourself about this word, and that's to say كيلوغرام. Okay, كيلوغرام. So you say ألف كيلوغرام, 1000 kilograms. What is a kilo? So you see this kilo is important because you can use it in multiple situations. كيلومتر is a kilometer. Okay. So بدون التركيب, without the assemblement, without the composition, we have the word غرام. Look, this what is a gram is written like this without the kilo, and it's with the كسرة, غرام, غرام. When it's put in a word, when it's attached to the word kilo, then the غين has a سكون. كيلوغرام, كيلوغرام. As for and I think I made a mistake, كيلوغرام because it's مضاف مضاف إليه like كيلومتر. أيضا, so when it's on itself, it's what? It's غرام. وتنطق بالجيم أيضا, it's also pronounced with the جيم. The word gram is also pronounced with the جيم with the same كسرة. So جرام or غرام. جرام أو غرام. وقد وردت كلمة كيل, the word كيل وردت, وقد, and indeed, the كلمة كيل, the word كيل وردت, is been mentioned في سورة يوسف, in سورة يوسف, الآية الخامسة والستون, and the 65 آية of سورة يوسف, مرتين, twice. It has been mentioned twice in Surah Yusuf, the word كيلون with the فتح on the calf. Okay, so somebody might say, okay, why don't we just say كيلون instead of كيلون? Like in the book, we have كيلان, the root form is كيلون. We have كيلان in the book because between 11 and 60, we have single form two فتح, ستون كتابا, 60 books, ستون دفترا, سبعون دفترا, 70 notebooks, 80 قلماً, 80 pens. Single form to fatha between 1199. So, السؤال, if we have twice in the Quran the word with the word كيلون with the fatha, why don't we just يعني say كيلون? The reason, السبب, والله أعلم, and Allah knows best, is this. لكنها, it's been mentioned twice in Surah Yusuf, ayah 65, in one ayah. لكنها ليست بمعنى كيلو, بمعنى الكيلو. ولكنها, but it, meaning the word كيلون, ليست بمعنى الكيلو. It's not with the meaning of kilo in those two ayat, in that ayah where it's mentioned twice. Okay, you can go back to the explanation. So when we ponder over the word كيلون with the fatha, كيلون, we find that the word كيلون has nothing to do actually with kilo. The word كيلون is a masdar, is the noun version of the verb كالا. كالا خالد التفاحة. كالا مثل وزنا, just like وزنا, he waited. Okay, so the process of weighting something on a scale is كالا يكيلو. كيلتو, I waited. كال خالد التفاحة. خالد waited the apples. تفاح is جمع اسم اسم جنس جمعي because تفاحة is one. إذن وزن خالد التفاحة or وزن التفاحة he weighted the apples. Okay, so كلت البرتقالة. I weighted the oranges. Okay, هذا اسم جنس جمعي because المفرد والتاء المربوطة one orange is برتقالة. كال يكيل he's waiting. كيل wait. كيلا waiting. فهو كائل so he's the one that's waiting. Who is the waiter? That the one who's waiting on the scale. والمفعول باسم مفعول is مكيل waited. الخضروات مكيلة. The vegetables are weighted, so you don't have to do it twice. إذن 60 كيلا 60 كيلوز. وما وزنك أنت and what is your weight. وأنت في نهاية الجملة at the end of the sentence ضمير منفصل زائد is an additional detached pronoun. You can drop it. وما وزنك and what is your weight. You want to make it stronger, you add the أنت for emphasis للتوكيد. وما وزنك أنت؟ الجواب the answer 100 كيل 100 كيلوز 100 كيل 100 كيلوز. As you have heard 100 has here one dhamma because it's مضاف. So the word 100 is always مضاف. 100 is always مضاف. When you mention 100 with something, if I just say 100 on itself, okay, I will not mention any word after it. I say mi'atun with two crystal clear dhammas. Okay, bidhammataini wadihataini with two clear dhamma. Lakin, anything that I will mention after the number 100, likewise 1000, elfun, it's always mudaf. So the word after will get a kasra. And what is interesting is that the word 100 and 1000, the word after both of them will be single form while being mudaf ilay. So in English you say 100 books. In the Arabic you say 100 book. مئة كتاب. In English you say 100 houses. In Arabic you say 100 house or 1000 house. مئة بيت. ألف بيت. On itself it's مئة and ألف. والطريقة الثانية and the second way لكتابة مئة for writing the word مئة. So we actually have two ways of writing 100. هناك طريقتان لكتابة لفظ مئة for writing the word مئة. أولا the first الطريقة الأولى the first way is like this. ميم همزة على الكرسي. همزة on the chair. تاء مربوطة. A tight تاء. مئة. Hundred. الطريقة الثانية you might be amazed and that's this way. مئة. Wait a minute. Is this not an alif? Yes, this is an alif. Written, not pronounced. مئةٌ. Okay. مئةٌ. مع عدم نطق الألف. Without pronouncing the ألف. So you say مئةٌ. This is very strange. This is not strange if you read the Quran often. If you are of those people who are reading the Quran on a daily basis. إذا كنت ممن يقرأ القرآن يوميا, if you are from those who are reading the Quran daily, فأنت لا تستغرب, you are not amazed, بكتابة مئة بهذه الطريقة, with writing 100 with this way, in this way. لماذا؟ وهي الموجودة and this is the one that is found فقط only this way is found. Which way? This one. This way. مئة. This is the one that is found. Only this one is found. The one with the alif. في القرآن الكريم in the noble Quran بين قوسين between two brackets طبعة الملك فهد the Malik Fahd print رحمه الله برواية حفص with the رواية of حفص. How many times? وذلك ثمانية مرات. Eight times in the Holy Quran. Eight times in the Noble Quran we can only find, we only find the word مئة written with a ميم and a ألف. Okay. أما مئة, as for مئة without the ألف فغير موجودة. It's not found in the Noble Quran written like this. Okay. Although, of course, for a beginning student of knowledge, this one is easier because you write it like you hear it. مئتون. But I can only say that both are common. Both ways are common, the Quranic way and the other way. Okay, انظر مثلا, look for example to سورة الأنفال الآية الخامسة والستون والسادسة والستون. سورة الأنفال 65-66. طيب, sometimes you come in a situation in English where you say, for example, you're not sure how many, for example, how many people, for example, so is it 700 or 400 or 300 or 900? So what do you say? Hundreds of people attended the funeral. Hundreds. Okay, it can be 900. It can be 700, it can be 300. Okay, so likewise in the Arabic we have a word for this, and that's the jam'u mi'atin. The plural of mi'atin is mi'atun. Okay, hadara mi'atun min al-musallin. Okay, so hundreds of praying people attended. Okay, hadara mi'atu tullabi. Hundreds of students attended. Okay, ghaba مئات الطالبات. Hundreds of female students were absent. غابت, عفوا, غابت, because that's feminine past tense. غابت مئات الطالبات. Okay, so مئات is hundreds. فائدة, a benefit إن شاء الله. مئات ومئات, يعني both of them, whether you write it this way, سواء كتبتها بهذه الطريقة أو بهذه الطريقة. Okay, معدودهما, معدودهما, the word after them, معدود means literally counted, so everything what you mention after the number is counted. So if I say 60 pens, the pens are counted. Okay, 70 books, the books are called معدود. So the ma'duduhuma of both of them, huma's dual form, of both of them, da'iman is always, are always mufradun, single form. So after mi'atun, whether you write it this way or that way, the word after it, the ma'dudun is always mufradun, single form, wa mudafun ilayhi, and mudaf ilayhi. Wa kadalika, also the word alfun, alfun. So, how do you say 1,000 books? Alfu kitabin. How do you say 1,000 female students? Alfu talibatin. You see, there's no changing, my brothers in Islam. It's not alfun and alfatun. Okay? Or mi'atun and mi'un. Don't change 100 and 1,000. They're just one word for both genders. Okay? Don't drop something or add something. So ألفٌ will never become ألفةٌ. And مئةٌ with تا will never become مئةٌ without تا. Okay? So ألفٌ أيضاً. So ألفٌ is always مضاف when added to another word. When joined to another word. So ألفُ كتابٍ. ألفُ اسم مضاف. كتابٍ مضاف إليه. طيب. Can you say, for example, thousands, like in England, like in English language, you say thousands of students. نعم. آلاف الطلاب. So if you're not sure how many thousand, you say آلاف, thousands. Okay. آلاف. Okay. آلاف الطلاب. آلاف الطالبات. So, نعم. And on itself, it's آلاف. You can use it with من if you don't want to make مضاف مضاف إليه. Say مئات من المسلمين. Thousands of Muslims. آلاف من المسلمين. So you can use من to stay away from the مضاف مضاف situation. But then we have من. And من اسم حرف جر. And then we have اسم مجرور. What gets a كسرة just like مضاف إليه. Okay. آلاف من الكتب. Thousands of books. طيب مئات الكتب. مئات الكتب. آلاف الطلاب. تشد on the ta and on the lam, not on the alif. إذن مئة كيل. And كيل is here مضاف إليه, as I've just explained. قال قاسم. قاسم said أنت سمين جدا. You are very overweight. You are very overweight. So سمين لغة literally means fat, but you don't actually say that to a person because I think the word fat in English is very negative, so you can better say you're overweight. So أنت سمين, you are overweight. Is he very overweight? Then you use the جداً, what means very. طيب. But why is it fat? Because as we will get in a bit, the word سمنون with a سكون on the ميم, فتح on the سين, سمنون is literally fat. Fat. Okay. So if you have fat, you call that سمنون. That is really the fat itself. Okay. So خالدٌ. نعم. So خالدٌ سمينٌ. خالدٌ سمينٌ. Okay. خالد's overweight. Is another way to say somebody is, you know, like overweight. نعم. هناك كلمتان غير سمين. Other than سمين, we have two other words. بدينٌ. It's also overweight. I try to avoid the word fat. بدينٌ وثخينٌ. Okay. So you can use all three words. سمينٌ, بدينٌ, and بدينٌ. We have done the word بدنٌ, what is body. بدنُ الإنساني, the human body, just like جسمُ الإنساني and جسدُ الإنساني. So بدينٌ, ثخينٌ, سمينٌ. هي سمينة, هي بدينة, هي ثخينة. للمؤنث for the feminine form. And the word سمين, my brothers in Islam, if you look to its derivement, it's a اسم فاعل من الفعل. It's a اسم فاعل from the verb سمين خالد, meaning سمين خالد. Khalid, he put on weight. He put weight on. يعني he became overweight. Past tense. سمين خالدٌ. يسمن. فعل مضارع. The present tense form. اسمن. Become overweight. سمنن. Overweight. وسمانة. هناك مصدران, two مصدر, سمنا وسمانة. فهو سامن وسمين. We have two اسم فاعل، سامن، وهذا اسم فاعل غير مشهور، this is not famous. And سمين هو المشهور، is the famous one. والجمع سمان. For those of you who are reading the Quran often, Allah Mubarak, they have come across this word سمان. انظر سورة يوسف، يوسف مضاف إليه، but it's ممنوع من الصرف، so gets a fatha instead of كسرة. الآية الثالثة والأربعون، the 43rd ayah of سورة يوسف, you will find that this plural. So you say هم سمان، they are overweight. وهي سمينة، and she's overweight. وهن، and they feminine. سمينات. ولا يوجد اسم المفعول، لا يوجد اسم المفعول. لاحظوا من فضلك، أما سمن، as for سمن، سمن is all يعني it's ghee. سمن is ghee. I told you brothers سمن is fat, but سمن is ghee. And the brothers, they know what ghee is, and they know the difference between ghee and butter. زبدتون is butter. Okay, and they know the process of making ghee. Now. إذن زبدة، butter، سمن، ghee. And this is the situation of brothers in Islam. And فائدة إن شاء الله، فائدة، a benefit إن شاء الله. خالد سمن وعسل، خالد سمن وعسل. This is such a beautiful statement. هذه عبارة جميلة جدا. It's a very beautiful statement, expression, and phrase. So, does that actually mean خالد is ghee and honey? The Arabs, when they say خالد or فلان, such and such person, سمن وعسل, they mean he's such a good person. He is a good person. رجل طيب. رجل طيب, a good man. Okay. هو سمن وعسل. Okay. Can sisters say that to each other, meaning in a feminine form? ممكن. ممكن. سمن وعسل. SubhanAllah, it's a very amazing way of describing a person. هو سمن وعسل. You don't need to ask after that, is he not an evil person? Is he not this? No, it means like he's Allahumma barik. He's the person you want to be with. هو سمن وعسل. طيب ويطلق السمين, and the word السمين يطلق على الإنسان, is being used, or it's the human being is being ascribed of. Described being سمين, but not only the human being, also والحيوان, also the animal. Okay. فعن عائشة وعن أبي هريرة, on the authority of عائشة and أبو هريرة رضي الله عنهما, may Allah be pleased with both of them, أن رسول الله, that the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم كان إذا أراد أن يضحي. If the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam wanted to sacrifice, to slaughter a sacrifice, ishtara kabshaini, he would buy two male sheeps. He would buy two male sheeps. Ishtara kabshaini adimaini, he would buy not only two kabshon, two male sheeps, but adimain, two great. Big and great male sheeps. Saminaini. Not a slim one, a cheap one, but saminaini. Okay? With a lot of meat. Allahumma barik. you would choose such a great ram, such a great two male sheeps, أقرنين, with horns. والله أعلم. فذبح أحدهما, so he would slaughter. ذبح يذبح, he slaughtered, he slaughters. إذبح ذبحا, فهو ذابح, the slaughterer, he slaughtering. ومذبوح, is slaughtered, with a with a نقطة on the دال. فذبح أحدهما, so he would slaughter one of them. عن أمته, for his ummah, for his nation, for his Muslim nation. Okay, look to the rahmah. He would slaughter one for his ummah. لمن شهد لله بالتوحيد. That's what the hadith say. For the one who witness, who witnesses to Allah with التوحيد, to his oneness, the people of التوحيد, who worship Allah alone. وشهد له بالبلاغ. And he witnesses to Allah that the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم has conveyed the message. البلاغ. The conveyment has been done. Okay, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم did not hold things behind. وذبح الآخر, and he would slaughter the other, عن محمد, for himself صلى الله عليه وسلم, وعن آل محمد, and for the family of محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. And the hadith رواه ابن ماجه, رقم الحديث 3122, وصححه الألباني. The number of the hadith 3122 and is being classified as authentic by الشيخ الألباني. غريب الحديث, the difficult words of the hadith. Caption is a ram, it's a male sheep, والجمع أكباش. سأقف هنا إن شاء الله وإلى درس قادم إن شاء الله. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك, أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت, أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.